September 18th Committee on Community Resources meeting, 5 o'clock. I will note that we are all here and we have quorum. I will also note that, as you may have heard, we're being audio and video recorded from Hope. And our first agenda item is public comment, but there is no public present. So moving on to the next item, which would be approving the minutes from our last meeting, which was July 17, 2017.
I move to approve.
Is there any discussion on the minutes? Thank you, Councilor Bidwell, for doing minutes. Oh, we should also, yeah, let's approve, we'll do, let's finish this motion and then we'll talk about our next minutes. Any discussion on the minutes? Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
I think I'll abstain just because I wasn't here.
Okay, so that's 2, 3 ayes and 1 abstention on the minutes. No other, okay, they are approved. So we still don't have an assistant, and I had said last time, so Councilor Bidwell very nicely did the minutes in July. I had said for this meeting, if we were still in this situation, that unless there was a volunteer, we would go by seniority, which means that Councilor Klein and I will flip a coin to see who takes the minutes. So I'm listening for a volunteer as I get out a coin.
She's given you plenty of time to volunteer.
Are you talking on a meeting by meeting basis? Or as a.
Yeah, I'd say, I mean.
This is just for today, right?
Just for today. You know, it seems that, you know, it had been before there was an administrative assistant who took minutes that the least senior counselor took the minutes. So I was kind of going with that tradition, but tweaked it in a fairer way to say that we would start with the least senior counselor, which was Councilor Bidwell, and then we would rotate through until
the
administrative assistant.
Okay.
So that's where we're at. All right.
Heads. So it's me and you.
You and me. Yeah. All
right.
Heads or tails?
Heads.
A lot at stake here.
Ooh. That is tails.
Now, we didn't define what that
so
means.
What is that?
Now.
Heads are then
it's
tails.
It's obvious she loses.
Well, I would
interpret. I'll take the notes because you have to leave the meeting.
Thank you.
That's how kind I am.
You are very kind.
Yeah.
But you made it work for it.
Thank you, Councilor Klein, for taking the minutes for today's meeting. We have 3 items that were referred to us, 1 back from August and then 2 from the September 7th City Council meeting. I am a little flummoxed because I had thought that Carolyn was going to come.
I would have thought so.
And talk to us about all 3 of these.
Mm-hmm. Was she actually at the meeting when, because they weren't originally referred to this committee, but they were after, I mean, it was amended at the council to include this committee.
Yes, but and
I don't know if she was here or
there not. Was I my understanding was she was going to be invited to come to this. Maybe that didn't happen, but when this agenda was created, that was what I was told, unless I misunderstood.
Do you want me to send a quick
if you could if she's
text
around
to her if I in the event that I can.
Yeah, I have to say I read the agenda and I looked at the ordinances, and if I don't have more explication, I feel a little bit lost.
Me too. I've got a bunch of questions.
So I assume someone would be here.
Yeah, I did too. So, and then
it came from Central Business Architecture.
And she staffs that.
Yeah, one's from planning and sustainability and planning, and one is historic commission, and then one is central business architecture.
Yeah.
All within her purview?
I think Sarah is staffs the historic commission.
Okay.
That's true.
And Carolyn, the other two, I believe.
Why don't we have like a bat line in here? It's so weird. Shouldn't there be a phone that connects all the departments?
Yeah.
Yes, we do.
Or at least a megaphone.
We could try calling.
See if there's anybody, oh, I saw Wayne pull out just, you know, as we were coming in.
Other than that, I mean, we don't have anything else on the agenda, so.
We'll see if I hear back.
Does anyone else have any new business or, something not on the agenda about which we could discuss within?
We can't discuss anything that isn't on the agenda, is that correct?
Well, yeah, but new business is something that we hadn't anticipated, I guess, right? That's the purpose of it, is something you hadn't anticipated.
Well, so would it be appropriate, for example, I was just talking to Dennis about the concern brought to me on this week from folks at Lathrop Community. So about 20 of them were all concerned about the environmental working group website that shows water quality in cities across the country. And so I was going to ask, I mean, I don't know whether it is or isn't appropriate to bring that up as a topic. That's a, I mean, it's community resources.
I know a lot about it because I looked into it.
Yeah, yeah, that would be, so I can just offline if you don't think that.
Well,
I've
talked with one of my fellow committee members on Public Works and Utilities about whether we should ask Donna to come and talk to that committee about that report.
Okay.
So, you know, I guess if it were to come to a committee for some kind of discussion, probably.
Yeah, it would make sense
Public
to be
Works
Public Works, yeah. Right. I mean, I think community resources because of, you know, water management, but.
Might be useful to have someone, I mean, even the mayor can speak to it because I spoke with him, and he spoke, of course, to the DPW director, but he could at a city council meeting if you make a statement, because I know there are people across the city who have expressed concern.
Yeah, that would be a.
So maybe we can ask to have it put on the agenda for our council meeting, just to have maybe the mayor address it, and then it'll also be live public information.
Yeah.
Carolyn just responded, I had no idea which three ordinances you're talking about. So I don't know where she is, but I don't think she's on her way here. Actually, it would be a little right for me to just call her.
So, I just called her in her office, but she didn't answer.
Oh, I've got her cell.
I mean, you could tell her what three ordinances, but at this point, I don't.
I mean, unless she wants to get on the phone and talk it to us, if she has it in front of her, if she's, you know.
To do.
Yeah, I don't think we're allowed to do that unless it's actually broadcast.
Right, yeah, that falls under the remote participation and stuff.
Yeah, I know, right.
So is it not deliberation to?
Hi, how are you?
Is it not deliberation to make a recommendation to the city council president that we put on the agenda of the upcoming council meeting, either having the mayor or somebody address us about the water quality report?
Address the full council.
Yeah.
Right, for this meeting on Thursday. Yeah.
Is that something you as chair would do?
So ask the president to have it on this Thursday's agenda, or?
Yeah, and I guess
but they'd have to,
he'd have to
make sure
the
mayor can
the
get the
office
DPW, get Donna.
I really do think it could just be the mayor, though.
Yeah, if he has enough.
I mean, but that would be up to council president to proceed in
right.
asking, right?
So, I was busy trying to find the number for Carolyn. So this is a water quality report from Donna.
It's about, have you seen any of this from Environmental Working Group? It's a website that's kind of gone around with, except for a number of, it's been
for
6 months or so. Yeah, although when I looked at it, they said they were not-for-profit, but they do apparently check water quality and had a report for the city of Northampton that was troubling for some people. And according to the DPW, there's erroneous information on there. Doesn't really, it's not relevant to what the city of Northampton maintains that we still have safe.
Right.
We meet all federal, state.
All standards. Yeah.
Yeah, I looked into it a little bit. And I actually haven't talked to the mayor. I'm talking about Director Lee Scully on Wednesday, but it seemed erroneous on two counts. There was some misinformation went from state DEP to EPA. But then, for me, the really troubling thing is that the standards that they use in judging is not EPA standards, not any state standards. It's
quote-unquote health guidelines.
The standards, the health guidelines that come from staff members of a task force in the Public Health Department in California some years ago that never made their way into any regulations or anything. And they're incredibly strict, like 1/100th of EPA standards. So everybody's out of compliance according to that.
I haven't seen something recently. I saw something months ago.
So,
yeah, maybe these folks were just late in getting it, but they want to meet with
us. So maybe they're not for profit, but it's an organization that is selling a product to filter your water.
Yeah,
so
right.
Essentially, it is if it's not for profit, they're at least it's how they exist as selling this filter.
Yeah.
So this
is
cloaked sales. Yeah.
And these folks at Lathrop are kind of gullible, you know, because they were saying, our immune systems are compromised, we're older.
I've had someone contact me very alarmed. You look at it on the surface and, gee, what's going on?
Right.
Okay, so Carolyn.
I've heard nothing.
I'll
just tell her we'll have to reschedule.
Is there something that you're here in particular to talk about?
We're just here for class.
Yeah,
oh,
we're students from the University of Massachusetts Amherst.
This is going to be the shortest and most boring meeting ever for you. I'm really, really sorry.
Could we ask some questions, brief questions at the end?
After we adjourn, absolutely.
Thank you.
Absolutely. Okay, so I'm sorry we all came down here for this, and I hope that it wasn't my error that kept Carolyn from coming, but I've been told that she was going to be invited, so. Hi!
Hang on, there may be something to talk about after all.
Carolyn just called me, that's why I'm here.
Oh.
I was still in the office and she was up.
Hi, Sarah, thank you for being here.
I think your workday should be over, though.
I want to. I have a little bed.
I'm going to recognize Sarah LaValle. We have three items on the agenda that we need some information about or further explanation on that I know you maybe weren't prepped to talk about, so thank you for coming to do this.
Sure.
The first one is an ordinance to amend 156 5A and 5C to allow CDA oversight over some exempt projects and to modify some exemptions.
Yes, so Carolyn just wanted me to let you know that we didn't know that this was coming to this committee, which is why we weren't here today. We thought it just went to legislative matters. So that has already been through, I think all of Carolyn's that she put forward have already been through the legislative matters.
Really?
I sit on legislative matters, and it was discussed in that committee that it was coming here.
Okay.
Yeah. So, and actually I just checked that with the chair too and told him again that it was coming here today.
Okay. I know there are various stages in the hearing process. I think the required public hearings have been held for some of them, but not for others.
Right. I believe we had a public hearing in legislative matters, and then we didn't further discuss it because it was coming here first.
Okay.
But we did have that public hearing last.
Okay, I'll have to have Carolyn follow up with you
about
those, but I can do the historic district
that is
before you.
Okay, so that is.
I mean, we still need to know the timeline for this
Okay, I don't believe that.
No, I mean, whether it would be safe to just continue it, that would put it off for a month because it would have to then.
Yeah, it should be. Carolyn said that the for those that did require a public hearing, it hasn't even been advertised yet.
Okay.
So that should be fine. That shouldn't be an issue.
Would it make sense to just continue that one until?
So we're talking about 17.37, the CBA oversight one?
Yes.
The CBA oversight, yeah.
That would be fine if
it should be. Yeah, I was just sort of, she didn't know it was on, so I was just reading her the agenda quickly, and she said that it hadn't been advertised, which I believe is all of them.
Okay, so so is there a motion to continue 17.367?
Okay, so
sorry. All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay. So then moving on to 17.383, which is
an ordinance to refine project categories for which local historic district review is required.
Yeah. It's pretty brief. I'll read it quickly. An ordinance of the City of Northampton, Massachusetts, providing that the Code of Ordinances, City of Northampton, Massachusetts, be amended to refine project categories for which local historic district review is required. An ordinance of the City of Northampton, be it ordained the City Council of the City of Northampton, and the City Council assembled as follows: amend the text with the additions, modifications, and deletions shown below. Modify existing ordinance subsection numbering to accommodate amendments. So this is subsection 195.5A.9, driveways, resurfacing of existing layout only, and then under that section, landscaping, grading, terraces, walks, we're removing driveways from there, and sidewalks, planting, pruning, trimming, removal of trees, shrubs, flowers, and other plants and grading, provided that no retaining walls are required, nor any alteration to the siding of any building. Then 19 is being struck, which is shutters removal only, but not installation of new shutters. 20 is siding repairs when using the same materials, color, and dimensions is being added. 23 is solar, this is being added, rooftop mounted panels only, if consistent with design standards. And then potentially exempt with a certificate of non-applicability from the Director of Planning and Sustainability or his or her designee based on the standards herein and the design standards. 11, siding replacement with the same materials and dimensions.
Okay. So just an overview of all of that? Okay, so this was a unanimous recommendation from the Historical Commission, which also serves as the Local Historic District Commission. We've had the Local Historic District Ordinance for about 15 years now, and this is just a little bit of refining to help us figure out what should be reviewed and what shouldn't be reviewed, just with experience with projects that have come forward and some that didn't come forward because they didn't need to, and the Historic Commission felt that probably some level of review would have been beneficial. So the driveways, for example, there's some confusion about, well, what's a driveway and what's a parking lot, and the new language will just clarify that all of that will be reviewed.
Okay. And same thing with the siding and
yeah,
the main changes are siding.
Yeah, it's just minor clarifications to let us know.
And then the solar is just to
solar, there was a little bit of confusion as to what exactly would be exempt, and the way that it was written, you could put solar panels in your front yard and that would be exempt, which the Historic Commission didn't feel was appropriate.
Okay.
If you're so ground mounted would no longer be, but rooftop mounted would.
Just rooftop mounted.
We do still want to encourage solar, but if you're putting it in your front yard, that definitely is a little bit of review at least.
Got it. Okay.
Can you explain that? You said that solar, the roof mounted would be okay, but ground mounted wouldn't because it would affect the historical.
It could potentially. In our design guidelines booklet, we have a few standards for how solar panels should look. So as long as those are being constructed in accordance with the design guidelines, which mostly deal with roof mounted, then those would be, but if you're putting something in your front yard, then that would need to comply with the full standards and would need a full permit from the Historic Commission.
Okay, thanks.
So it doesn't disallow it, it just makes sure that we know what's going on.
On solar, where it refers to design standards, is it clear from the overall context what that means? Which
yes.
design standard?
Yeah, so earlier in the ordinance, which I didn't include because it's very long, there is reference to a design guidelines booklet.
Okay.
which is available both in line, online and in hard copy.
I just had one other question.
Sure.
I had one member of the commission who was talking about this, anticipating there was going to be some tweaking, talk about whether this was specifically referring to Elm Street Course District, whether fences should come under where do fences now fit?
Fences currently are exempt. It's something that we're grappling with.
So this wouldn't touch that.
It doesn't
fences
touch
is
it.
The main exempt, but
it
it's
does
been
not.
Discussed.
We hope to come forward with a proposal for that sometime in the future.
Okay.
Currently, fencing, as long as it meets zoning standards, is completely exempt and doesn't need any kind of review at all. Fencing hasn't generally been a problem within the Elm Street District, but there are a few that have gone up that maybe don't complement the district as much
yeah.
as they possibly can.
Okay.
But it's a difficult thing to try.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, just curious.
Any further questions? Okay, so in the interest of Sarah's time, let's move on to the next one and then we'll vote on this after. That's okay. So the next is 17.390, an ordinance to amend the zoning map 350-3.4 to expand the highway business district on North King Street.
Yeah, I know for sure that this one has not been advertised. So if you continue this one, that wouldn't be a timing issue.
Okay.
Do you have any information on it or?
I do not.
Okay. Okay, does anyone have any further questions for Sarah while she's here? Thank you
okay.
so much
Thank
for scooting
over. Yeah, I think generally the city clerk lets us know that, or the council clerk, but since sort of things are sort of in flux.
Right.
And
they're
in limbo.
That's what I thought was going to happen, but something, you know,
right.
things are a little bit limbo.
So we apologize.
No, I likewise, I apologize. Thank you for
right,
coming
thank
over
you.
And doing this literally last second.
Sarah. Oh, thank you.
So on 17.390, is there a motion?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay, and then 17.383, is there a motion on that? That was the local historic district review.
Move to recommend to the full council, is that what we need to do?
Which positive recommendation?
Positive recommendation.
Positive recommendation.
Yes.
I would say, yeah.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Excellent. Thank you. Again, is there any further new business that we'd like to discuss or no? In that case, is there?
I move we adjourn.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.